instrument should be your flipper.
I can't say. Here, I'll cover it up.
Flat side down, right?
Mm-hmm.
So now do I just... You don't want me to rear anything yet?
Just pick out where the black is. And go right about there. All the way back as far as you can with that instrument. Your looks like your nail may fall off at some point.
The whole thing?
Mm-hmm. It's loose from you prying at the edges. One more time.
These like the imitation English anvil splitters. Because they don't look as pointy or sharp as the ones
I've seen. Different brands. If you can't get it, that's fine. Do the same thing with the other one.
That right here.
Mm-hmm.
Told you it's sharp, huh? It's like cuts through them like butter.
Okay. Get your straight hemostat. I just want to remove one side. Some of those times you're not taught the right way. Best thing to do is to go up under and
mm-hmm.
back in this corner.
And turn.
And I'm going all the way down as far as I can. My hands are out.
Okay.
I'm just going to do this.
Turn in. Okay. Rolling it, don't pull, just roll it. Just back.
What was that? No, 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 no. I told them I will not see anybody that registers after 10:15.
Okay.
Don't pull it, just roll it in a circle. Both corners with an instrument to be sure there's absolutely nothing left.
Looks good.
Mm-hmm. See how there's some blood under the middle
mm-hmm.
over here from the silver nitrate, I'm not too sure.
Mm-hmm.
And the black stuff was silver nitrate. And
you
stepped
aside. Yeah, you really, what are you doing with that? What are you trying to do with it?
Me? I didn't do the silver nitrate. I just let it grow out, and then I have somebody else do it.
Here. What do you mean?
Just hold pressure on it for a minute.
Mm-hmm. One inch Kobe?
Yeah, I have Kobe on it.
One inch?
No,
that
I have...
That looks like 2 inch.
Let me...
Cut in half? Can we just cut in half?
Because it'll grow back out and grow again, and then...
It may not. It depends on how much people have removed it well in the past. I mean, that's a pretty good resection, so...
I've been phenol twice, and it always comes back.
Well, if you want at some point, if you don't want a phenol, if you want to have it excised, we can do that.
You do like the acetinal, or...
Mm-hmm. You just have a hole there.
You usually put one or two stitches on the sides.
You do that, then. Don't you have to do that in the OR, though?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right here. This is my OR.
Do you want the clean or?
No, so you can do the treatment though. You just, you know, beware of what you're doing so that you don't contaminate and you keep it.
So you can actually do that in one of these treatment rooms?
Mm-hmm.
This one?
I don't use a clean typically. I'll just use the 1 inch.
Oh, okay.
Because I like to be able to get people back into their shoes.
Oh, okay.
And I'll typically dress this, do whatever else I need to do for the patient. And if it does bleed through, just wait and rewrap it
okay.
with another small bandage. in your office setting, you're not going to
manage
the advantages because you're handing out surgical shoes, and you're not going to do that.
No, they're
right. Okay?
Thanks, Dr. Martin.
Yeah, I'm going to get you something to use on there overnight. Domper, wet to dry, astringent, non-pressure.